Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for March the 19th of 2020, well, it is titled M13, the Great Globular Cluster in Hercules. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a globular cluster, which is a grouping of stars, maybe 100,000 stars or so, all closely compacted together, so much closer than we're used to looking at stars in our portion of the galaxy. In our galaxy, the nearest star to the sun is over 4 light years away, but here you might have 100 stars in that little distance. So instead of having one star 4 light years away, you can imagine having 100 stars and what the night sky might look like with that many stars packed so close together. So here it is, and a globular cluster is a sort of a remnant of the early history of our galaxy. So when our galaxy formed, these may have been some of the earliest things to form, and they still orbit around our galaxy. They are some of the oldest objects in the universe, dating back 13 billion years in some cases, and we can tell their ages by the stars that are left in them. They have not had star formation like our galaxy. They underwent a complete burst of star formation early in their history and have since just been living their lives. And what that means is that the oldest stars that we can find that are still around tell us the age of the globular cluster. And in many cases, we find them to be 12 or 13 billion years old, pushing the age of the universe. Now, we can also see other things in this image. You can see a galaxy off to the upper left, so a distant galaxy that happens to be off in the same distance. And there are also a pair of bright stars here, a red one just to the left of the cluster, and a blue star to the right. Now, the coloring of the stars tells us something about their temperatures. The hotter a star is, the more high-energy radiation it will emit, and the bluer it will appear, because the highest energy radiation in the visible spectrum is the blue and the violet. And that star is emitting more of those colors and therefore is a very hot star, several times the temperature of our own sun. The star on the other side, the red one, is much cooler than our own sun, emitting only lower energy radiation, so reds and infrareds, and it probably has a temperature about half that of our own sun. So one thing we can tell when just looking at images of the sky is to get a rough idea of the temperature, how hot or cold an object is, just by looking at its color and looking for the red or blue tinges that we see. So that was our picture of the day for March the 19th of 2020. It was titled M13, the Great Globular Cluster in Hercules. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be when night divided by day equals 1. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.